morning. Welcome to those of you joining us at home to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Let us call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Enlighten, O God, with compassion the hearts of your children, sanctified by penance, and in your kindness grant those you stir to a sense of devotion, a gracious hearing when they cry out to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. King Nebuchadnezzar said, "Is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you will not serve my God or worship the golden statue that I set up? Be ready now to fall down and worship the statue I have made whenever you hear the sound of the trumpet, flute, lyre, harp, psaltery, bagpipe, and all the other musical instruments. Otherwise, you shall be instantly cast into the white hot furnace. And who is the God who can deliver you out of my hands?" Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered King Nebuchadnezzar, "There is no need for us to defend ourselves before you in this matter. If our God, whom we serve, can save us from the white hot furnace, and from your hands, O King, may he save us. But even if you will not know, O King, that we will not serve your God or worship the golden statue that you set up." King Nebuchadnezzar's face became livid with utter rage against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He ordered the furnace to be heated 7 times more than usual and had some of the strongest men in his army bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and cast them into the white-hot furnace. Nebuchadnezzar rose in haste and asked his nobles, "Did we not cast 3 men bound into the fire?" "Assuredly, O King," they answered. But he replied, "I see 4 men unfettered and unhurt walking in the fire, and the 4th looks like the son of a god." Nebuchadnezzar exclaimed, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sends his angel to deliver the servants who trusted in him. They disobeyed the royal command and yielded their bodies rather than serve or worship any god except their own God." The word of the Lord. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne above the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Prayer. But the reality is, when you and I leave
any kind of selfishness, any kind of ulterior motive, anything that is not related to God, anything that remains of this world, selfishness, sinfulness, pride, God does not have enough room to reside in our hearts. Our hearts are only so big, they cannot hold an infinite amount of love. God is infinite. He cannot be contained. Yet he wants to come into our hearts. The more we open that space for him, the more he is capable of dwelling in us. And when we get to heaven, if we get to heaven, all of our hearts will be filled, and everyone will be equally satisfied. But the reality is, some will be way more full than others, because some of us in heaven, our hearts will have expanded into this gigantic ocean, capable of receiving more of who God is. But many of us, even though we come to heaven, we will still be completely filled, but we'll only have a little tiny teacup, or a bowl, or a mug that can be filled. Everyone will be filled by God, but each of us, to their own extent, relating to how much we are able to die to ourselves and empty ourselves of self and selfishness and worldliness, so that God can truly reside in us and can find room in our hearts.
Trusting in the Lord who saves, let us offer our prayers and petition. For the Church, may the Holy Spirit continue to uphold her in times of trial. Let us pray. For leaders of nations, may the Lord bless them with the gifts necessary to serve their people with justice. Let us pray. For those burdened by illness or addiction, God's promises and generous love be a comforting presence to them. Let us pray. For we who are gathered here to worship, may the Lord give us the wisdom and faith to make our homes true domestic churches. Let us pray. For those who have died, may they, especially for Shirley Massaro and Roland Brunion, for whom this Mass is offered, may they find eternal peace and rest in God's presence. Let us pray. We pray for Father John's mother, who's having some health complications and is in the hospital at this moment. Let us pray. For our personal intentions. Let us pray. God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, hear our prayers before we bring them to you, confident in your care for us, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
my sisters and brothers that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Receive back, O Lord, the sacrificial offerings which you have given to the offered to the honor of your name, and grant that they may become remedies for our healing through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Bless your thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received the heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Mystery of faith. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the
blessed apostles, Saint Anne, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray.
May the mysteries we have received, O Lord, bring us heavenly medicine, that they may purge all evil from our heart and strengthen us with eternal protection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We'll be splitting palms for Palm Sunday after Mass, so that'll be today, right now, in St. Joachim Hall. So if you'd like to help, think of it as a Lenten penance that you can do. So thank you for anyone who is able to help us. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Please kneel.